Hello everyone, I am MD Joshimuddin and welcome back to Learn Cybersecurity BD. In today's video, we will dive into a topic that every network administrator and enthusiast must pay attention to: protecting your network from ARP and DNS spoofing attacks. Now, why is this so crucial? Well, imagine this: you are managing a network, whether it's at home or in an office, and suddenly an attacker silently intercepts your traffic. They can redirect your users to fake website, steal sensitive credentials or information, and even take down your entire network. Scary, right? That's the devastating power of ARP and DNS spoofing attacks. They are silent, effective, and can target anyone, anywhere. But here's the good news. With your MikroTik router and the right configuration, you can fortify your network against those threats. In this video, I will show you exactly how to secure your network from ARP and DNS spoofing step by step, ensuring that your network stays safe and any user with infrastructure stay protected. So stick around and let's learn how to turn your MikroTik router into the fortress against ARP and DNS spoofing attacks. We came here on MikroTik and we have to dynamic ARP. We have to see the dynamic ARP here, which dynamic ARP list. All the ARP in here is dynamic, so let me target a IP. I have target an IP here and double click on it. I copied the MAC. I like to copy the MAC. Copy the MAC. Make sure that I can able to make a static ARP, add a static ARP for this IP. So I have to delete first dynamic ARP. I have removed it and add the ARP. Put the IP here, 192.168.102.39, and paste the copied MAC here and select the interface 2 for static ARP. You may know static ARP is secure than dynamic ARP, so we have to put all the ARP static, not dynamic. My second rule will be creating a log to watch the route or watch the log that I can find the transaction. So I came in my terminal, IP, firewall, filter, add chain forward is equal to forward action log is equal to yes, log prefix, oops, I like to add just the screen, log prefix is equal to double clone IP traffic. Look at the command carefully. This will create a log. Now I have created a log here. Here is the graphical mode: forward, action, log traffic. That will create a log for IP traffic. If I click the log here, it is showing IP traffic, all the IP traffic. And you can filter it to watch this. You know, segmentation is another part to prevent ARP spoofing. So I am creating VLAN here to segment my network. Interface VLAN, add name is equal to VLAN 10, VLAN ID is equal to 10, and interface is equal to Ethernet 2. So I am creating a VLAN for Ethernet 2 to segment my network to prevent ARP spoofing. If I go to interface and click the VLAN, click the VLAN here. Here is showing the VLAN and Ethernet 2 VLAN 10. Here ARP will be ARP proxy. ARP proxy can prevent ARP spoofing for transact the route. ARP proxy allows the router to answer ARP requests on behalf of other devices within the same subnet or VLAN. Instead of device broadcasting ARP request and trusting response directly from other devices, the router intercepts the replies to this request to centralize ARP resolution, which can mitigate ARP spoofing risk. Here we will create a filter rule for this MAC IP, MAC and IP. So I am copying the MAC here, and create a filter rule for filter the MAC, which will be block the ARP spoofing. So I am IP firewall. From the terminal, I am writing the command IP firewall filter add chain is equal to forward source address is equal to 192.168.102.102.39 and source MAC address is equal to, which I have copied earlier, source MAC address is not, look at this carefully, is not this MAC. That is, this MAC will not be matched, this MAC, if this MAC not matched with this IP, any route will not be forwarded, action dropped. So if this IP and MAC will not be matched, any route will not be happen, or any route will not be gone through the IP. So that I have attached this MAC with this IP to prevent ARP spoofing. Action drop. To prevent DNS spoofing, we have to put the Google DNS or Cloudflare DNS. So at first we will go to my terminal, IP DNS set servers is equal to 8.8.8, which is Google, comma 1.1.1.1, and remote access, remote request enabled. So comma and allow remote access, remote request is equal to yes, so that it will prevent some DNS spoofing. For this rule, hit enter. After that, create a DNS server here, DNS, and allow remote request. That's it, we're going forward to our next rule. So we are going to block malicious DNS response. For blocking DNS response from any malicious DNS, we're going to our terminal again, and IP firewall filter add chain is equal to forward then protocol is equal to UDP, UDP, and destination port is equal to 53. As you may know, 53 is DNS port number. So we are putting this action is equal to drop. This command is for UDP port. So we are going to make a command. This we are protecting DNS spoofing. So we put a command here. That's it. We're checking our, here is the graphical interface. So we'll copy this and make the rule for TCP again. Going back to our terminal, copy the command. We just will change the UDP for TCP. We are protecting the port number here. So we will protect this port number for TCP also. Copy the command for preventing writing. Paste. We'll change the UDP here instead of TCP. That's it. Hit enter and it will create another rule for TCP. Look at the command carefully. Enter. If I go to firewall, look at this. I have created two rules here. One for UDP and one for TCP to protecting the port number. To protecting the port number or to protecting the DNS spoofing. Here is graphical interface here. Forward TCP 653 action drop. We're going to our breeze setting. For general setting, we are going to our breeze and enable the firewall rule. So if I enable the firewall rule for breeze, firewall rule will be applicable for breeze also. So we are enabling those rule for breeze settings. Accept those rules. You can put many kind of techniques to prevent ARP and DNS spoofing, but we have to remember for prevention of ARP and DNS spoofing, you just creating a rule, not conflicted to the other rule that you created for another purpose. So if you get this video helpful, please subscribe my channel. And we'll be meeting on my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.